schön, dass ihr alle so früh hier seid.
So I'm happy you're all here so bright and early
Linus,
to Erdgeist listen to Frank Linus, Erdgeist
und
Constanze
beim diesjährigen Jahresrückblick.
At the year in review.
Nexus, der steht bei mir.
And
ich
also Nexus,
da.
Who's not
und
written
Nexus.
Down. Also Nexus, yay. Have fun.
Digitalisierung durch dringend unsere Gesellschaft und unsere Nutzung informationstechnischer Systeme und des Internets schreiten unangefährlich voran. Das bietet neue Chancen, schafft Freiräume und ermöglicht uns zu synergieren. Das Internet beeinflusst unser gesamtes öffentliches und privates Leben. Über 90% aller Unternehmen in Deutschland sind Internetunternehmen. All diese Companies could be hacked.
The danger of hacking is more present than ever.
Well,
I need an emergency number so I can call it.
Don't trust the provider.
Don't trust the state. But I don't change my behavior. I don't trust my airbag.
I don't trust my airbag.
Well, please understand, I don't want to give an answer.
Ein Teil dieser Antworten würde die Bevölkerung verunsichern.
A part of these answers would make the insecurity in the population.
Lass mich an einem Beispiel sagen.
Well, can we give you an example?
You have a safe car with airbags.
Sie können
sicher die Verkehrsregeln halten.
Follow the rules of the street properly.
But
if you drive without care, you can still... Well, I need an emergency number from you.
Der CCC Jahresrückblick.
CCC Year in Review. Frank Rieger, Constanze Kurz,
Linus
Neumann,
Nexus und
Nexus
Erdgeist.
And Erdgeist.
Ein Riesenapplaus.
Please give a warm round of applause.
Guten Morgen, ist Mikwana.
Morning.
Ja, eigentlich hat der Herr Innenminister für uns well, ja das Jahr jetzt Minister schon zusammengefasst.
Has already summarized the year, but we want to go into a bit more detail. And just like every year, do a bit of a review on the year 2015.
Auch ein bisschen Rechenschaft ablegen.
We also want to give account about what the publicity team did and also all the work that all the various other regional CCCs did in the EFRs and the meetings. We want to give you some numbers and we'll tell you some tales, things that happened, or things that we were told. And if something weird happens,
der ist ja unter der Krisennummer erreichbar.
Frank can answer and then mention them sometimes.
Wer sich für den Song interessiert, ich habe hier nochmal
the people who are interested in the
URL,
in the song,
oh,
here's
schön.
The URL. Oh, thank you.
Hey, willst du das haben? Ja, ist aber nicht angewendet.
Right.
Wir gehen das Jahr meistens so von
we normally start from January to the end of the year,
Anfang,
but not at the beginning, because we want to
Statistiken zeigen,
we'll just share some
zum Beispiel zu unserer Mitgliedschaft oder auch
regarding membership,
Presseanfragen, die kommen, solche Art von statistischen Angaben.
For these
immer
kind
haben
of statistics,
ja
but at the beginning,
mit den Nachwehen vom letzten
at the beginning of the year, we always have to deal with the consequences of the previous Congress. And we always talk about that at the beginning. We have a little bit of an anecdote from
Welt
N24
Press,
who told us
wir sind jetzt
we are now relevant.
Um es Maha zu sagen, es ist ein inklusives Wir. Ne? Also
well,
wir
it's
sind
an inclusive
ganz doll
we.
Relevant.
We all are.
Als Relevanzkriterium für die Wikipedia?
Is it relevant in the sense of the Wikipedia?
Da bin ich jetzt nicht sicher.
Well, I'm not sure about that. We're not sure.
Okay, also wir haben natürlich immer am Anfang des Jahres
all right, we always, always have to something stuff to do at the beginning of the year,
mit einfach
dealing with the consequences of the Congress,
und natürlich
handling the press requests,
und so
and also
aber wir waren eigentlich für
the demolition of the various CC things.
Ziemlich aktiv,
well, we were
schon
pretty
Januar,
busy, even in January 2015.
Februar, März,
normally there's like a relaxed phase at the beginning. Well, it also depended on the political situation at the moment, which...
Ach, ich wollte noch ja nicht, fällt mir ein. Ich fange noch gar nicht mit dem Januar an. Wir machen
jetzt I'm not going to start with January yet.
Let's start with statistics.
If you remember last year, does anyone remember last year?
Da sehe ich ja wenig Hände oben, das heißt also,
I don't see a lot of hands.
12,000 Besuchern, die wir dieses
with
Jahr
12,000
haben, so verdammt viele neue Leute da
there's a lot of new people,
führen, dass das Haus
which
voll,
lead to the fact that the house is completely
Leute,
super full.
Ja. Davon zu schicken
so we have to start rejecting people.
Im nächsten Jahr wahrscheinlich eine kreative Lösung
finden. Well, next year we'll have to think of a creative lottery. Solution. Maybe a lottery?
Nee.
No.
Wir müssen, weiß nicht, wenn jemand eine tolle Idee hat,
if someone has a cool idea,
ccc.de,
please tell us
at
press@ccc.de. Maybe an idea, a location that's even bigger than the CCR. Well, we've already checked, actually.
Aber
there is no such thing.
Wir sind jetzt offiziell wirklich
well,
voll. Wir haben das größte
we're
Gebäude
officially
der
full.
Bundesrepublik
we have the
das,
biggest house in the Republic.
Relevant wäre und
and which would be relevant for us.
Wir müssen damit klarkommen, dass
and
wir
have to deal
so
with the fact that we had a lot of success.
So, viel Erfolg hatten,
so that our mentoring project had a lot of success,
und,
so that we
were
really being overrun. Our distribution platform, digital platform is still being used, but not enough. But a lot of people still apparently seem to want to take part in the flesh. It's nice that you're here, but... But, well, we have to say that actually the Congress Everywhere story is kind of a bit starting to being a bit hidden since the last few years. But now we planned a whole new event in Hannover so that you can people could watch from everywhere. Even people who weren't that interested in originally, who might not have the idea to come to the Congress, but they can still do a lot. Well, one of our ideas is to decentralize. Well, maybe we think about decentralizing the Congress itself so that in future still we can still have a Congress that can still grow, but slightly more decentralized and slightly more dynamically.
Da sind wir für jede Idee.
We're open for any kind of ideas.
Ja, apropos Verteilung.
Well, speaking of which, we're
ziemlich gut verteilt.
We're pretty well distributed. Well, what a segue.
Im Bundesgebiet.
In the whole republic.
Mittlerweile eigentlich fast allen größeren Städten Erfa-Kreise.
We have Erfa in almost every major cities. Well, we have to talk about what depends on what we can see the postcodes, and you can see where the density is higher. That where it's lighter, slightly fewer. Well, we don't actually do publicity for numbers. Well, you can see where the density is going up and where the density is down. Well, as always, we can see that we have two EFAs outside of Germany, one in Zurich and one in Vienna. I think we have four additional
Karlstreffs,
which are still, well, we still can be found on CCD, the only side that still hasn't fallen over yet. We also have a plot, which is the requests per day, which doesn't begin on the 1st of January, starts in January, in December. That's why we've marked 1st of January. There's always a big wave after Congress. You say we don't do publicity, but this is probably the best publicity you can possibly imagine. Well, we're not evangelizing, hey, Jehovah's Witnesses style. Well, we still don't have any teams in the pedestrian areas. Well, I'm not sure about all the EFAs, actually.
Also man sieht jedenfalls, wir haben so eine kleine Welle wahrscheinlich an, wo bei zwei Drittel so die kleine Kurve herkommt.
You can probably imagine where that little curve is coming from, at two-thirds.
Ich hab's gehört. Ja, genau, also klar, beim Camp gibt's auch immer so ein paar.
There's always a few people.
Neuentritte allerdings war dieser kleine Tisch, wo man den
unfortunately, the small table where you could request membership was very hidden. A lot of people weren't able to find it, even after a long search. It's different in the Congress because the incentivization is much bigger and due to the access and also the pricing.
Well,
taking it together, we have growth, just like every year. Just like the last 14 years, this community is growing. Both in memberships, in terms of memberships as well. Yeah, I would like to say that. We have over 6,000, but we don't yet have over 9,000. I don't know if you're allowed to say the official numbers. The reason is the following. We also have some problem about people who are not paying, who get three strikes or three reminders. I'm not sure if we're allowed to count them still. Anyway, we have more members than before. We're going to say where they come from, mainly from Germany. You can say 6.6% that are not from Germany. Excluding Germany and Austria and Switzerland, where a lot of people speak German. Also the number of countries where we have members has also increased.
Viel spannender als wo die Leute physikalisch herkommen ist natürlich.
A much more interesting question is where they're physically, where is it, where is their emails hosted and etc. etc. And we have a lot of newcomers.
Sehr viel mehr geworden. Das ist der Platz 4.
We have one that has increased a lot, which is number 4, Postier.
Ich finde ja, dass man so nach den Nachrichten des letzten Jahres vielleicht
following the news from last year, you should think about where you should run your primary email account or think about maybe you should have a secondary email account in order to sign up to the computer. There are enough providers that will give you your own domain for almost nothing, so you can put your name in and so you don't have to. You don't have to come out as a Google Mail user here, maybe as a bit of homework. I would like to, people hate us, they're going to hate us if they say, don't change your email addresses, don't change your email address, they're going to hate us in the admin. If possible, everyone at the same time tomorrow morning. Just like all the work, just like our press work, is all volunteering. And it's a lot of work they have to do. Can you go back?
Das ist die tägliche Belastung, die
das daily work that the office in Hamburg has to deal with every day. Well, there are, as you can see, there's almost no day where they don't have anything. So if they take a week of holiday, they come back, they can look at the least two-digit number of requests. Well, they really dealt with all the requests very promptly last year. It's really well done. Well, it's cool to have such people who are using their free time to like keep it all running. Well, we can say for all teams, at least I can't think of a single team, if you look at the whole city, which hasn't increased. If you think about the office team, about the press team, the streaming teams, the various different teams, various projects, they've all grown. And they've grown also in terms of members. Well, all right, the security. Well, it's impressive that we don't have to scale up the security team. You have to think about the fact. You really have to think about that. We started at 4,500 people, and we got up to 12,000, and we really didn't have to. We were able to scale up without a big incident. It says a lot about the great community that we have here.
Well, we had,
before this Congress started, we had a few incidents. We had some threats, threats of violence, or some verbal attacks. It happened, but we always reject any such thing. Well, people always say that it's a joke, but we want to... especially this community that comes together, we really want to keep it without violence. And we take such threats, we completely reject such threats, but given the number of people, it's a very, very peaceful and quiet. What was the threat potential we estimated from the last camp compared to the Dalai Lama? Were they more dangerous?
I'm
pretty happy that no one came and... didn't come here and try to stop the Congress based on some 19-year-old having made a video. Luckily, we don't want to run a football camp. Well, we just want to talk about some like promptly things, looking back at the year, talking about social media.
An der Seite sieht man
we can see on the side the numbers
for AdChaos updates. At ccc.de is a
pretty automatic account
that
posts the entries in the blog. You can see the number of followers.
Für diese Accounts, aber auch die freien
we
Netzwerke,
also use the independent networks.
Excluding
Quitter and the Diaspora as well.
Man sieht die Zahlen,
you can see the numbers.
Für Chaos Updates, ist also
you can
kein
see the numbers from both, also in both cases.
Also letztlich so einmal am Tag im Schnitt.
It's just like about once a day, approximately. The numbers for December are slightly outdated. So.
Aber
it's about 72.
Relativ wenig benutzte
but it's a
account,
little used account, really, with a lot of followers,
offiziellen Mails,
where all official entries are being posted.
And
last year, more and more in two languages to translate more and more of our, we do our best. But the translation team has also grown in the last 2 years, and in these days you can't publish a private blog post without getting a translation directly from the translation team the next day.
Wir haben jetzt mal so die right. Top 7 der am meisten geretweeteten
Postings,
weil die, ich glaube, aus meiner Sicht auch einen ganz guten Rückblick
Because
für
I think
den Beginn so des Jahres
good
bieten.
Look back at the year.
Und zwar haben wir zum einen
we
sehr
on
viele
the one
geretweetet
hand,
worden, die
a lot of retweets for the Apple TV stuff. Surprisingly,
ja, ist etwas schade, dass
it's a bit of a shame that in the year 2015, when we talk about gated communities, we have to talk about Apple,
wo diese ganzen,
where the all these Apple devices, well,
Anteil ausmachen.
They are still a large part of this whole technical part. All right,
Es ist so gewesen, dass Menschen aus dem Chaosumfeld eine
well,
App entwickelt
from
haben,
the
auf der
from
man
the around the chaos the they developed an app
können sollte,
where you should be able to see CCC using the Apple TV, but Apple decided
weil dort
to reject it
unpassende Inhalte
because there were unwanted content was being distributed, including themselves. Well, there were some hacking videos or something on CCD.
Das Abstruse.
Well, the weird thing is, that's really weird. That's how did that happen?
Also das Abstruse daran ist, dass
the crazy thing is
State of the Art
Bluetooth
hacking
there was also
genannt wurde, das
there
ist von 2005.
They talked about a State of the Art Bluetooth hacking
noch
video from 2005.
Sind die crypto hacking export restrictions aus dem
more
Jahr
even more interesting the crypto export restriction from the year 1999.
Einerseits möchte man sich an der Stelle
on the one hand you ask yourself
sitzen,
what kind of people are making these decisions. On the other hand, well, if the policy is to censor these things, and we will accept the app, that's a really bit of a weird policy. Especially given that the YouTube app is still present, and you can see the same videos on YouTube. Well, that was a bit unfair. Well, now the YouTube app is also gone.
Sind Mitglieder vom CCC Frankfurt, die das gemacht
those
haben,
members
die haben
of the CCC Frankfurt,
sich auch darüber geärgert haben,
they were pretty angry about it.
Gemacht,
they have
auf den Seiten vom CCC Frankfurt. Und das war eigentlich überhaupt nicht geplant, dass es irgendwie so bundesweite Presse gibt.
There was no plan for that to get be national coverage.
Translation Team und hat da
and
auch
immediately the translation team came and
translated.
Actually, it's not even not just national, but also worldwide coverage. And everyone noticed that Apple overreaction by Apple and sort of showed that they have the finger on the trigger regarding the content. And they obviously decide for the users. They say that Google shouldn't be the only ones to control what information you should be able to get. But well, it also, I think it hit the zeitgeist a little bit because in 2015 there was a lot of small examples that related to this. It hit the like general mood and other people have experienced similar things, this kind of content, automatic content censorship. Well, I think people, that's why people really, really got popular. Well, because it also had Apple and CCC, well, it fit even better. Well, the other thing is that the international media really received this very well, and they immediately put the links in their videos so that the efficacy of this method is probably not fully. They also had the fingerprint video from Starbuck, or did they not realize that? They didn't put that one on there.
Okay, wir werden nicht weiter über Apple TV reden. All right,
let's stop talking about the Apple TV, we just don't mention it.
Since
it was on
top 7. Direkt daneben.
And right next to it was a tweet about the PhD thesis about our defense, Ministry of Defense.
Ich hab's nicht ausgesprochen.
I didn't say it. I did not say it.
Eigentlich nur, weil in dem, weil man
well,
in
just because you could see in the wiki exactly
was dort für
what kind of
akademische Fehler gefunden wurden,
what kind of in quotation marks academic mistakes, but the work itself is also linked there.
Naja, es ist nicht unbedingt ein Hacker-Thema,
it's not necessarily a hacker topic,
dass,
but it's very interesting.
Nach dem Tweet ist ja ein Wiki, man kann sich da beteiligen.
Well,
sich wohl auch
after the tweet, there's a wiki, people can participate. And a lot of people started participating after that.
Ja, dann haben wir weit verbreiteten Tweet zu der Straßenzeile. Da kommen wir aber später noch drauf.
The,
wichtig ist mir noch eine Geschichte
query.
Über...
I also want to mention a story about the BSI, the Ministry of Security. There was a leak by an expert which talked about the fact that the BSI and the BMI, the Ministry of Interior, and the
BMI unterstellt,
which is under the Ministry of Interior, for many years they claimed there was no collaboration with regards to the no technical collaboration with regards to the state Trojan. If you remember, in 2008 there was a court order from the very top then it was still called online perquisition.
Dann hatte man and
at Netzpolitik,
they published also the internal communication
from those offices, which made it clear that
this so-called non-collaboration
was changed with regards to this version. At the same time, it was made clear that they should continue to claim growing the public that there is no collaboration,
but you should still get
source code analysis by the BSD.
Well, nach dem Urteil,
after the ruling, it was a bit of a difficult position because they had to think about
what kind of thing they should do.
So the collaboration between the federal criminal office and the BSD should be kept secret.
We were happy that it was so widely distributed.
So it's a reproduction of the leak.
Also diese Zusammenarbeit ist ja ganz amüsant. Das Bundesamt für Sicherheit in der Informationstechnik hat ja eigentlich die Zielvorgabe, uns zu schützen.
Has the aim to protect us.
Und ich habe mich dann mal mit dem Herrn unterhalten.
Talked to Herrn Hanno, who said, well,
seine Auffassung natürlich auch ist,
in his point of view, that's his point of view, yeah, that they did that.
In dem Moment, wo sie dabei helfen, diesen Trojaner sicher zu machen.
Making this Trojan more secure, well, that's what they did.
Allerdings ist also die offizielle, also da gab es natürlich auch offizielle Meldungen, also eine von der BSI,
that said, well,
uns ist die Abwehr von Trojanern das einzige und ausschließliche
the only objective is to defend from Trojans.
Hange ist ja mittlerweile im Ruhestand. Wir haben ja, wie viele schon mitbekommen haben,
retired.
Einen designierten neuen BSI-Chef, der ja Begeisterungsstürme ausgelöst hat.
Is really extremely popular everywhere.
Was ist sein Rufname?
Name again?
Weißt du jemand? Ich glaube Cyberclown, oder?
Yeah, I think Cyberclown. Yeah, that's right.
Ja, das wäre ja das erste Mal in der Geschichte der Zentralstelle für Chiffrierwesen und das Bundesamt für Sicherheit in der Informationstechnik, dass ein Nicht-Techniker oder Nicht-Mathematiker, also jemand, ein Ökonom,
an economist,
diese technische Behörde führt.
Charge of this technical.
Das Wort Ökonom so als Schimpfwort raus.
I've never heard someone say the word economist in such a deprecating way.
Also, ne, ich glaube, er ist Diplom-Fachwirt für man kann es ja
verinnerlicht das mal bitte alle, wenn man irgendjemand fragt,
if someone asks you about, just say Cyberclown. That's sufficient.
Der Mann heißt Schönbohm. His name is Schönbohm. Den sich vielleicht einige noch erinnern, denn er hat ja doch einen berühmten
Well, he had a very famous Minister of Interior dad. It's just a complete coincidence, as we said.
We
are demanded completely independent. Something about... I don't remember. Why did he step down?
If
someone has leaks, well, we'll take brown envelopes.
Well,
our demand has always been that the BSI should be independent
and it should be
separated from the Ministry of Interior. And of course,
someone
should be in charge of this office that who has a
technical competence.
Or maybe we should put it under the Ministry of Defense. Sounds like a good idea. Oh, don't give them ideas.
Also wir wissen ja aus den Snowden-Veröffentlichungen, da geht es BSI ja bereits als Schlüsselpartner und
BSI
mit diesem Leak
ist auch klar, dass BSI
zumindest teilweise in der Zusammenarbeit mit dem BKA Trojaner-Sachen gemacht hat, ist natürlich für die Vertrauensbasis keine gute Sache.
Genau.
Jetzt kommen wir zu den Top 3, die sozusagen ja auch schon so ein bisschen dieses Jahr zusammenfassen.
Wir hätten diesen Tweet an Platz 3. This tweet on number 3.
Etwa im Mai so eine Meldung, die sich auf sagen, wir sind ja nicht in Berlin. Ja. Also das Gebäude in Berlin Mitte bezieht diese von einem Wassergraben verschönerte
Trotzburg. Yeah, like portcullis, really castle.
Ja, ihr wisst ja, da ist noch der Wassergraben. Yeah, also wenn die Russen mit dem Panzer kommen, fallen sie in den Wassergraben.
Also falls die BRD einnehmen wollen. Ich weiß nicht, gibt es
eine rationale Begründung für den Wassergraben?
Don't know, there's not really a rational thing. Crocodiles?
Eine rationale, Frank.
A rational, Frank.
Ich glaube, da führt die alte Panke lang und sie wollten da einfach nur einen schönen.
I don't know, maybe you just want to.
Schönes Flüsschen. Ach so,
angeln.
Have a nice river to fish.
Nee, jedenfalls kam diese Zahl von 1,044 Milliarden. Ich konnte nicht mehr so richtig nachvollziehen, wer diese Idee hatte. Irgendjemand hat es in einen Kindergärtner umgerechnet. Und offenbar haben wir damit auch so eine Art Zeitgeist getroffen, ohne dass da jetzt nicht mein Link bei war, nur so ein.
Also vielleicht dazu, das war gerade die Debatte, wo die ganzen Kita-Streiks liegen. Da kam dieses
Kita.
Und das ist so aus so einer Diskussion aus mehreren Leuten entwachsen. Und irgendjemand, also wir haben das versucht, in alles möglich umzurechnen, um ein Gefühl für diese Zahl zu bekommen. Und irgendjemand war dann, ich weiß auch noch, wer es war, aber ich
sage
es nicht, die Zahl, man könnte ja mal Kindergärtner draus machen.
You
und
could make kindergarten
da kam diese ziemlich, wie ich finde, ziemlich beeindruckende Zahl raus.
Astounding number.
Kann man mit dem Geld wesentlich sinnvolleres machen, als
could do
so
something more sensible with the money
sowieso nur die Wasserhähne geklaut werden.
This thing
they just ja, natürlich.
Aber vielleicht sollte man Kindergärtner einfach als Essenbereich halt jetzt standardisieren.
The
da fielen mir auch einige andere Projekte ein, so Jäger 90, wäre jetzt richtig, Eurofighter heißt er jetzt, also könnte man ja auch mal
like
umrechnen.
Eurofighter, gut, calculate that.
Ja, also mir haben sie den noch als Jäger 90 vertickt, aber also das wäre jetzt wirklich peinlich, wenn der noch so hieß, aber das ist das selbe Projekt,
just
oder?
Just made a typo.
Na, egal. Well, wir kommen zu Top 2.
Top 2.
Das ist der vom Januar, der Aufruf January zur Selbstverteidigung, wo wir offenbar auch so eine Art Zeitgeist getroffen haben, nämlich die Forderung des CCC zum Ausstieg aus der unverschlüsselten Kommunikation, der ungeschützten quasi.
When we wanted und to say to get out of unencrypted stuff.
Und im Laufe des Jahres haben wir dann gesehen, dass der eigentlich ungehört verhallt ist. Wir hatten irgendwie im Herbst ganz großes Thema, dass man plötzlich dafür abgemahnt wird, wenn man sich davor schützen möchte, von irgendwelchen großen Buchstaben, Zeitungen, die Adware installieren zu lassen. Man muss jetzt inzwischen deren Werbung konsumieren, inklusive der über diese Ad-Networks verbreiteten Schadsoftware, um diese Inhalte zu konsumieren. Ich glaub,
also wenn du da hinklickst, bist du aber schon selber schuld.
If you go there,
ich
you're
bin im Presseteam, ich muss dem hinterherklicken.
Ich darf
einfach mit meinem eingeschalteten Ad-Blocker gerade nicht mehr schauen, was die über uns schreiben. Also
I can't see what they write about us with my
Ad-Blocker. Ich schicke ein Belegexemplar, weil ich kann es nicht mehr klicken.
Bild is at least sending an exemplar to us, because I can't click you, sorry.
Aber unabhängig sozusagen von dem deutschen Klein-Klein war natürlich die Crypto-War-2.0-Debatte international ein Thema. Also das ist in den USA stark debattiert worden, haben wir natürlich auch verfolgt. Das ist in Großbritannien sehr doll debattiert worden und natürlich dann auch hier so ein bisschen im Nachgang. Ich finde bei uns in puncto Kryptoverbot oder jedenfalls in diese Richtung, finde ich, war es noch relativ moderat. Da fand ich die
Debatte. Kann man sagen, dass es da eine klare Ansage gab. Also es war halt so, dass
das
relativ kurz vor stattgefundenen Terroranschlags in Deutschland ja sogar vom Innenminister unterschrieben, eine Charta für Terrorattack verkündet wurde auf diesem merkwürdigen IT-Gipfel. Das war sozusagen das einzig sinnvolle Ergebnis.
Du meinst die Krisennummer-Veranstaltung?
Genau, es war so das einzig sinnvolle Ergebnis dieser Veranstaltung, aber immerhin ist es tatsächlich so, dass sich immer mehr abzeichnet, dass wir in Deutschland quasi auf so einer Ausnahmeinsel sitzen, wo also insbesondere von Seiten der Innenbehörden keinen ernsthaften Druck in Richtung von
Krypto-Hintergrund,
sondern im Gegenteil halt eben dieses Papier, was sagt, dass Deutschland halt der weltweit führende Standort für Ende-zu-Ende-Verschlüsselung sein soll. Da kann man sich drauf ausruhen, dass diese Lage statisch ist, so, insbesondere wenn man sich anguckt, dass die Chinesen haben gestern ihr Hintertürengesetz verabschiedet, was in weiten Teilen inhaltsgleich mit dem von Großbritannien ist.
Mit der Begründung?
Ja, mit der Begründung halt fiese Terroristen.
UK,
lustigerweise regte sich natürlich sofort das US State Department darüber auf, weil sind ja die Chinesen.
Enraged about
natürlich
because
aber nicht
Chinese,
über das britische Gesetz, weil das sind ja die
guten Freunde. But not about the Britons, because,
also diese Hintertür-Mandate-Geschichte, also zu sagen, liebe Firmen, wenn ihr halt irgendwie Systeme baut, die Verschlüsselung verwenden, dann baut sie gefälligst so, dass ihr uns im Zweifel
den Keytext geben könnt,
neue Versuch zu sagen, wir wollen als Staat keine Krypto-Hintertüren haben, wir wollen aber zumindest in den großen kommerziell verbreiteten Systemen halt den Zugang zu den Informationen für die Geheimdienste haben. Das ist ja sogar so eine neue Welle, damit wir auch nächstes Jahr noch intensiv zu tun haben.
Es heißt ja Sicherheit durch Verschlüsselung und security Sicherheit trotz Verschlüsselung. Und diese zweite Sicherheit, die da gemeint ist, die nennen wir Staatstrojaner. Und die werden wir dann im nächsten Jahr hoffentlich meistern.
Wir kommen gleich nochmal zum Staatstrojaner. Da haben wir ja nochmal einen eigenen kurzen Absatz zu. Aber also ich fand schon spannend, wer die erste Crypto-War-Debatte noch mitverfolgt hat oder später nachgelesen hat für die Spätgeborenen, der wird natürlich merken, dass es große Unterschiede gibt. Also insbesondere fand ich die amerikanische Debatte, die schon auch für den europäischen Raum wichtig ist, weil die deutschen und europäischen Politiker dahin schielen, die war schon interessant, weil die sich eben nicht in den üblichen parteipolitischen Hickhack verloren haben, sondern interessanterweise man sehr deutlich gemerkt hat, dass es eben große ökonomische Einflüsse gibt, dass eben die Wirtschaft da auch ihre Interessen versucht durchzusetzen und die sind natürlich teilweise eben nicht gleich mit der Regierung. Also es war eine, finde ich, zumindest spannende Debatte, die sich da entfaltet hat, und der Crypto War ist sicherlich noch nicht beendet, da werden wir weiter darüber debattieren. Aber meine Befürchtung, dass wir dann die Krypto verboten kriegen, ist sehr gering.
Wie gesagt, zumindest in Deutschland sehe ich es nicht, in anderen europäischen Ländern bin ich mir überhaupt nicht sicher. Also gerade Frankreich zum Beispiel, Großbritannien sind ja gerade halt auf dem abgleitenden Ast aus der Demokratie raus, und da bin ich halt nicht sicher, dass da nicht ein Kryptoverbot durchaus versucht werden wird. Es hat dann wenig Auswirkungen, weil alles, was du irgendwo in der EU verkaufen oder vermarkten darfst, kannst du auch in jedem anderen EU-Land machen, aber zumindest werden sie es halt versuchen, denke ich.
Ich habe noch mal eine Frage, kannst du es endlich auflösen? Hat mir sehr jetzt deine Krisennummer?
Do they have your emergency number? Also meine Telefonnummer ist jetzt nicht so schwer herauszubekommen. Sein Referent für den komischen IT-Gipfel hat sie jetzt gehabt.
Vielleicht sollten wir uns noch so ein großes
Jahr? Hat er Ja gesagt? Summit with that too. Did you just say yes?
Ich brauche ein großes rotes Telefon.
Ja, darauf
Big red rote Telefon.
Ja, yeah, also I'm waiting for that. Also es ist eine interessante Frage, ob es ein rotes oder ein grünes Telefon sein sollte. Ne?
Red or green.
Also weil eigentlich müsste es ein rotes sein, weil also in der klassischen Nuklearnomenklatur sind die grünen Telefone, die sicheren Telefone zur eigenen Leitstelle, und die roten Telefone sind die Telefone zum Feind.
Red telephones are the telephones to the enemy, so that would be fitting.
Aber um mal diesen Top-2-Tweet und die Crypto-War-Debatte abzuschließen, auf die wir sonst nicht weiter zurückkommen. Mathe lässt sich nicht verbieten, das weiß ja sicherlich jeder im Raum. Dennoch sollten wir uns, glaube ich, dafür einsetzen, was unsere politischen Ziele sind, selbst wenn jetzt die Befürchtungen vielleicht nicht hier in Deutschland nicht so groß sind.
Even though we don't fear
dann kommen wir zu dem Top-One-Tweet. Es wird hier niemand überraschen, das ist, glaube ich, die letzten Jahre immer so gewesen. Es war natürlich die Veröffentlichung, als die Recordings alle fertig waren vom letzten Kongress.
Das hat dann doch alle Retweets
geschlagen. Das war, glaube ich, jetzt die letzten Jahre immer so. Leute freuen sich dann halt, wenn sie
den Gesamtcontent
vom Kongress downloaden können. Und generell, also das Streaming und VOG-Team, die rocken ganz schön
streaming
hart.
VOG-Team, they're rocking pretty hard. So.
Also ich glaube, Stand heute Mitternacht war, dass ein Großteil der Aufzeichnung von gestern schon online war.
Das ist einfach the most Bestzeit. Things of yesterday were already online, which is really, really fast.
Großen Applaus zum VOG-Team.
Big round of applause for the VOG-Team.
Wir schließen jetzt auch gleich diesen Social-Media-Blog ab.
So, let's close this Social-Media-Blog.
Man konnte eigentlich so ein bisschen das Jahr darüber auch ganz gut ablesen. Wir wollen halt noch eine Sache erwähnen, die, glaube ich, auch damit zu tun hat, dass wir dieses Jahr noch das Camp hatten, nämlich, dass auch das Events-Blog deutlich mehr benutzt wurde. Das Team ist da natürlich größer, ist mehr als nur das Presseteam. Also wir haben versucht, auch gerade weil viele Veranstaltungen waren, aber nicht nur für Camp und Kongress, sondern auch für die kleineren Veranstaltungen, den Airfacet-Tracker zu nutzen. Da gibt es jetzt auch ab und an Bilder. Also wir haben dieses Blog doch etwas verstärker belebt insgesamt. Und es ist auch oft zweisprachig, sodass man, auch wenn man nicht Deutsch spricht, da lesen kann.
Speak German, you can read it pretty well.
Okay, haben wir den Social Media Blog damit abgeschlossen?
Are you through with the Social Media thing?
Ja, dann haben wir eine kleine Auswertung gemacht über die Anfragen, die bei uns so reinkommen. Nexus hat da mal was vorbereitet.
Nexus put in something for us.
Ja, so ein bisschen.
Das,
was man oben links sieht, ist das Jahr 2014 gewesen. Und unten rechts ist das Jahr 2015. Das sieht wesentlich homogener
right,
aus.
Warum?
Der Grund dafür ist, dass irgendwann mal jemand einen Spamfilter aktiviert.
Because we put down a Spamfilter.
Das war auch bis ungefähr
November
eine
November
gute
so?
Idee.
This was good till November.
After that, Software-Update gelaufen sein. Dann
we
hat
had to do a Software-Update.
Deswegen müssen wir uns, glaube ich, ganz tolle nochmal bei der Presse, bei Journalisten entschuldigen.
Sorry to
all
the journalists.
Weil nämlich viele Akkreditierungsmails zum Kongress einfach in diesem Filter gelandet sind.
Mails landed in the filter.
Und wir haben tatsächlich vor diesem Kongress echt da gefailt, weil
failed hard wir, before the Congress. Ja,
da fiel dann plötzlich, nachdem wir bemerkt haben, da stimmt was nicht, dann kam das so nach ein paar Wochen an die Oberfläche.
After a few weeks. Dann so 250 Mails.
There were 250 Mails. Yeah, sorry for that. False positives.
Von Overblocking davor waren
wir
auch. Yeah,
classical case of overblocking. We warn against that as well.
Aber
bei dem Wurde noch auffällt übrigens, was ich noch sehr auffällig finde, ist, wie freundlich uns die Presse,
also als ich diese, ich habe wirklich nur einfach mal alle Tickets eingesammelt, versucht, Workshops darüber zu bilden. Da sind jetzt Stockwords rausgefiltert. Und das, was dann plötzlich zutage kam, war eigentlich eine sehr höfliche, freundliche Sprache.
Really
es sind so in diesen Workshops tatsächlich erstaunlicherweise die typischen Buzzwords, die man so erwarten würde, die man
teilweise
gar nicht enthalten.
Not there.
Also ich sehe kein Cyber.
Wo ist der Cyber? Wo ist der Cyber?
Wo ist der
Spamfilter?
Der Spamfilter.
Wobei die WordCloud, die Mails, die im Spamfilter gelandet sind, mittlerweile wieder beinhaltet. Das heißt, die haben wir zurückgeholt, nachbearbeitet und also wie gesagt, muss man einfach sagen, die Presse geht mit uns relativ höflich um und die Anfragen sind, wir bekommen sehr viele, sehr gut formulierte, exakte
really
Anfragen, auf die man auch wunderbar antworten kann,
wo
Journalisten sitzen, die
das
Thema auch verstanden haben.
Das
finde ich manchmal sehr schön.
And I think that's
nice.
Ich muss
sagen, der Nexus ist relativ neu bei uns im Presseteam.
Nexus is new at the press.
Wir haben vor zwei Jahren das erste Mal einen
Presse-Workshop
gemacht.
We had a press workshop.
Ja, es ist wieder die Zeit vergeht. um auch die Pressearbeit, die einfach bei der Anzahl von Anfragen, die auf uns einprasseln, irgendwann von auch älter werdenden Team nicht mehr alleine zu leisten ist. Und Nexus ist vor drei Jahren zu uns dazugestoßen, hat sich super bei uns eingelebt und freut sich immer noch wieder, wie so die Innenansicht ist auf die Presseanfragen.
Ich weiß nicht, wo ihr jetzt hinfahrt. Ich wette mal weiter. Ich habe noch diesen Hinweis vom
Office. Yeah, I don't know where this is going. Just go.
Klassifiziert Mails von ccc.de gerne mal als Spam.
Yeah, with this.
Ja, ist ein Problem, weil wir natürlich auch die Mailläufe und so.
Also ccc.
Spam. Einer der Punkte ist, es ist nicht nur Google, sondern irgendjemand erzählte neulich mal, es gibt ja so Kinderschutzfilter, so Proxys und
Children Safety Filters.
Seiten des ccc als Computerterrorismus klassifiziert.
CCC Pages are often classified as computer terrorism.
Auf Deutsch.
Computer terrorism,
also in German. Deutscher Softwarehersteller.
Also nochmal kurz zurück zu diesem Google-CCC-Mails als Spam. Das ist ein nicht ganz subtiler Hinweis an die Journalisten. Liebe Journalisten, wenn ihr eure Mail bei Google speichert, ist zum einen keine gute Idee, falls ihr irgendwie versucht,
Journalismus
zu machen. Zum anderen kann es halt sein, dass ihr denkt, ihr bekommt keine Antwort von uns, was auch mal vorkommen kann.
Aber es kann
halt auch sein, dass ihr in eurem Spamfilter landet.
Also sucht euch einen anderen E-Mail-Provider. We are in your spam filter, so yeah, look for another provider.
Und Nexus war gerade im Statistikmodus und hat dann noch weiter
gemacht. Statistiken
sind super.
And went through with it. Yeah, I like statistics.
Ja, in dieser Grafik sehen wir. ich habe da mal so die Ticketzahlen aus 2014
mal beachtet,
mit Spam und 2015 gegeneinander gestellt. Was wir dieses Jahr eigentlich gar nicht so hatten, war so ein enormer Peak, wo ganz viele Anfragen in einem Monat kamen. Das liegt vielleicht daran, dass wir so keine wirklich schlimmen Snowden-Themen oder sonst irgendwas dazwischen hatten. Man sieht aber auch, dass irgendwie die eigentlich relativ kontinuierlich die Anfragen reinkommen.
Pretty continuous.
Davon ist ein sehr großer Bestandteil Interview-Anfragen.
Interview
teilweise kommen dann noch Sachen dazu, wie Hintergrundgespräche, teilweise
Video-Dokumentationen,
also auch sehr, sehr viele Vorträge, die üblicherweise sehr, sehr viel Zeit kosten. wo man dann gerne auch mal durch die Gegend fahren muss, dort dann irgendwo in irgendwelchen Städten, die man bislang gar nicht kannte,
irgendwelche Vorträge hält.
Das werden wir natürlich auch machen. Nicht immer nur sozusagen das kleine Team, aber so die Beteiligung an Veranstaltungen und Mitwirken an den Diskussionen dort betrachten wir natürlich auch als Teil der Öffentlichkeitsarbeit in gewisser Weise. Aber da hat sich auch so ein bisschen dezentralisiert. Da gibt es natürlich auch in den AFAS Leute, die für manche Themen ganz gerne machen.
Er
hat ein bisschen zugenommen, würde ich sagen, aber auch nicht in hohem Maße.
But not that much.
Okay, wir müssen jetzt mal diesen Statistikteil hier abschließen.
Let's go through the statistic thing. Okay, do it.
Wir könnten noch sehr viel mehr sagen, weil man schon mal die Daten irgendwie da rauskramt und nach Zusammenhängen durchsucht, findet man Dinge, aber das ist vielleicht auch nicht so interessant. Wir werden stattdessen jetzt so durchgehen durchs Jahr. Wir haben aber ein Thema davor, was uns eigentlich das ganze Jahr beschäftigt hat, wo wir jetzt kein spezielles Datum haben. Das ist natürlich die Vorratsdatenspeicherung, ein langjährige Thema, jetzt mittlerweile 15 Jahre für den CCC. Die meisten wissen, im Dezember jetzt sozusagen ist die Vorratsdatenspeicherung in Kraft getreten. Die übergroße Koalition hatte keine Mühe, diese Vorhaben durchzuboxen, hat sich da auch nicht irritieren lassen von dem höchstrichterlichen Urteil hier in Deutschland oder dem höchstrichterlichen Urteil in Europa. Das ist offenbar wie so ein so Untot, wie so ein Zombie, den man irgendwie nicht killen kann, kommt immer wieder. Nur die Begründung hat sich so leicht gewandelt und manchmal der Name. Wir haben aber auch sofort im Dezember, also da irgendwie ein paar Tage in Kraft, die ersten Ankündigungen und auch schon die erste fertige Verfassungsbeschwerde, verschiedene Gruppen, also soweit mir bekannt ist, mindestens vier von Juristen und Journalisten und Abgeordneten und Aktivisten tun sich da in Gruppen zusammen und werden das wiederum nach Karlsruhe
bringen.
Der CCC ist daran mittelbar beteiligt, zumindest an einem dieser vier Teams. Da wollen wir auch mithelfen, was den technischen Teil betrifft. Für mich war interessant, dass die erste Verfassungsbeschwerde, die von Journalistenverbänden unterstützt wird und auch von einer Abgeordneten und von weiteren Medienverbänden, sofort dieses Thema der sogenannten Gesamtüberwachungsrechnung aufmachte. Das ist ein Begriff, den die Richter in Karlsruhe mal geprägt haben. Also dass man eben nicht nur auf ein Gesetz schauen muss, sondern eine Gesamtüberwachungsrechnung aufmachen muss. Und das fand ich interessant, dass gleich in der ersten Verfassungsbeschwerde darauf abgestellt wird, dass man eben die Gesamtheit der Erfassung von Datensätzen und gerade auch von Telekommunikationsdaten sehen muss. Also, ja, ich finde die Situation sehr unbefriedigend, dass wir da immer zu den Gerichten schielen müssen, was ja auch immer lange dauert, aber faktisch ist es natürlich auch so, dass technische Inkrafttreten natürlich nicht passieren wird. Es gibt nämlich noch keine Durchführungsverordnung, keine technischen Vorgaben, da werden wir mindestens über ein Jahr noch warten, ehe die in Kraft hat.
Zumal da halt natürlich auch der Knackpunkt liegt, weil das Verfassungsgericht hat ja in seiner letzten Entscheidung dass diese Daten nach dem Stand der Technik gesichert werden müssen, was die IT-Security angeht. Wir kennen alle den eher nicht so schönen Stand der IT-Security gerade. Das heißt also, wir wissen eigentlich, dass es gegen einen gezielten Angriff mit staatlichen Ressourcen momentan keine Möglichkeit gibt, so große Datenbestände über so viele Provider liegen, effektiv dagegen zu sichern. Das heißt, wir können davon ausgehen, dass ausländische Geheimdienste auf diese Daten natürlich scharf sind und auch an die ran wollen. Das heißt also, die Frage, wie halt die technische Richtlinie ausgestattet
wird. Inländische auch, zum Beispiel Bayern.
Nein, die dürfen ja ganz legal, die müssen ja nicht hacken. Ne? Und die also diese Frage halt, kann halt dieser Anforderungsverfassungsgericht überhaupt
nicht beantworten. So, this is a question that the highest court cannot answer
right now. Und da werden wir halt sicherlich, denke ich mal, auch sehr genau hingucken.
And we will definitely have to look very closely at all this.
Entstehenden öffentlichen Debatte halt teilnehmen. Also
take part
die Frage,
in the public discussion
wie die Sache da weitergeht,
and so the
ist eigentlich wahrscheinlich so,
how does this continue is kind of similar to last time. So it will be, there will be some discussion, there will be a huge discussion, and this is basically the repeat of last year's discussion.
Ich wollte nochmal auf unsere alte Idee Three Strikes Regelung vielleicht hinweisen.
So I wanted to talk about our streaks, three strikes ruling. So basically, politicians that, talk three times about the law that will be then cancelled by the highest court, that maybe we should like vote them off from office.
natürlich irgendwie, also ich empfinde das auch und ich glaube, dass mit vielen so, die sich eingesetzt haben gegen die Frauenseitensprechung,
als eine gewisse Niederlage. Also ich meine, Heiko Maas als Justizminister, der
sich ja profiliert hat, for example,
Heiko Maas, the Minister of Justice, who was against the data retention, that he went away, and that was kind of frustrating. But there's positive aspect as well. So one thing, for example, we knew this about the questions from the press, the technical understanding of this, well, this actually improved a lot. So 10 years we've been writing about this, and people have been writing about this, and we know about metadata and what you can read out from metadata and movement profiles. And so a majority of the Germans, the Germans who voted for Merkel as chancellor, so those people are actually, the majority of those people are actually against data retention. So there's some change between now and when the fight really started 10 or 15 years ago. So people knowing about, like, more people know about that they have actually data retention in their bag. So men, please help me. So it's kind of frustrating, but oh well. So while we're talking about data retention, we can segue into a country with data retention. You remember the data retention helps us and saves us. And so you could, like, afterwards you could check where the terror was, like, ordered by a secret service. Okay, so actually, so if you look at 2015, like from a review, then you see the attack on Charlie Hebdo kind of different, because in January it was kind of a shock, because we couldn't know how the year would actually continue, and that there would be the attacks on Paris. But we had talked to other NGOs and wanted to prevent an intensive hysterical debate, and we're kind of like into the preventing the strong values that we have. So actually, like, in hindsight, it seems kind of like timid, but we couldn't really know how French policy would react after the attacks very much later in the year. So in my opinion, it's not only the question about surveillance laws, how they changed in Europe, but also how freedom of speech and freedom of the press was debated and talked about, especially about Charlie Hebdo, because they had covers of a very critical of religion and cynicism and lots of humor, and it was written on these signs, this "Je suis Charlie," but in practice, not everyone accepted Charlie Hebdo as satire, like just next to surveillance. It was also a thing about freedom of speech. So in January, we also were doubly active, because we were for transparency laws, and long time. So in the Hamburg Senate, there was an initiative from initiatives, and among others, the CCC. There was a law about transparency. And actually, Hamburg is the second one, now, because there's actually the country of Rheinland-Pfalz, where they also have in the whole county or country they have a transparency law. And even like a member of the CDU party, she would cancel the transparency law. But it was about actually getting that existing law into law against the people who think that they would have to enter their data, enter their data into existing transparency registrars. And we actually went juristically against these people. So there's no solution yet, because the courts are not the fastest, but there were papers against papers, and like and we think that this will actually be a decision that will be a precedence for other public organs, how to look at this. Would we look at what kind of public organs and public things will this law be applicable to? So not only so maybe we think that all public or all state owned offices should be applicable for this. Okay, so we will inform you when we have a decision, when we have any news, but we don't think the court is as quick as us. Alright, so we've been called all the time when something is being hacked or was hacked. In this case, it was very, very bad cyber terrorism presumably against the Islamic State, against a French TV station. They were off the internet for a time, and of course speculations went high, and they were completely wrong what actually happened and what happens with what is cyber terrorism and what are the capabilities that cyber terrorists have. And when we look at this, we try to be kind of unenthusiastic, because usually the explanations are way simpler than huge cyber terrorism. And in this case, a screenshot gave us the answer how this hack was propagated. So we see behind the journalist in this TV station, we see the passwords on the wall. So the bad cyber terroristic attack vector was a mobile phone with with photos from a pizza station. So this way of should we have blacked those out? But are they still current? So if he still has, if he always has his press conferences at this place, then maybe you should go those. But maybe it's not enough pixels, so that we needn't black it out. So afterwards, it was interesting, the discussion with the members of the press, how it is in their redaction. So should we have to change the passwords, they asked. Do they have HD cameras? So the funniest thing we saw in this context was in one redaction. So they were still at the wall, but they had a little curtain in front of the passwords. So not every pizza service guy will see the passwords this way. So you go there, you just open the curtain. Okay, you can understand it. No. See. So you're in the press office and of a website, and you're just there at night. You don't get a lot of money, and you just write your stuff, and then you gotta put stuff into YouTube. So you go there, open the curtain, and you type in the password, and they close the curtain. That's the ones who have the urgent news button. Now, password management is hard. Let us go shopping. So it's not only at the media like this, but obviously, this TV station thing has made other people think about it. Even though, like, the background was kind of funny, and like questions like at the members of the press, like, how is it in your press office? And they were like, All right. So we have lots of fun with it. Mm-hmm. This is happening all through the year, kind of. So someone somewhere in the internet, a sack rice for someone. People are asking us, and sometimes we don't feel like answering, because we can't really say anything about it. We can't contribute anything. But in this case, it was kind of fun. Maybe we should have a scalar, like a Richter scalar. So from the passwords are behind you, and up to no, it's still not a hack. So maybe if there's actually like treason RSA tokens, maybe this is actually a hack. But not everything where people don't secure their systems well is actually a hack. Maybe not. So maybe you're putting your passwords into the camera is not a hack, but someone actually took up your friendly offer to look around and look around in your systems and maybe update your systems to a more secure version. Okay, so because such as these things actually like get more and more, the states actually tried to create a IT security law. So Linus was very strong behind that. Okay, so I think last year we talked about this already, that we wanted to tell the Bundestag how we would like to what we would like the state to do for the IT security law, and then we just put it aside and wrote an IT security law for the for the Ministry of the Interior, and actually we could we looked at their laws. We actually found out that there was no improvement in IT security at all for normal people. So normal people were not at all secure. It was all about companies, and they should be helped. Their security should be improved by giving them even more bureaucracy in the area of IT security. And whoever is actually has a job in IT security in company, that they know that actually we don't really need more IT security bureaucracy in this company, but less would actually be better. So all this documentation and bureaucracy actually takes time that actually could be put into improving the security, and so we think the resources are actually misjudged. So the very important topic was that the people who have like critical infrastructure, they need a security concept. So as if they didn't. So this is such a fnord. So they say you get a security concept from the BSI, from the Minister of the Interior. So basically a stack of paper. So you have to propose that. So in order for it to not to make it too much work, you have to actually talk about other companies in your area. So maybe there's the four people that are like representing one area of companies with their concepts, have their stacks in front of them, then have a checklist. All right, do you guys have that? No, we don't. So we take that out. So that means it's very logical that they have the lowest common denominator from whatever they came up with. Then they go to the BSI with that, and they will have a look at their then and then tell them you'll have to adhere to this security concept now, and if not, so which company would be stupid enough to actually hand in something they couldn't adhere to? But obviously there will be like a huge amount of time invested to actually do this, and I predicted and that this would happen, and like lots of companies actually sent me private email that where they say this is exactly what we're doing, like this is right. So are you actually hoping that the IT security laws they're passed the Bundestag once the designated BSI cyber clown actually gets into office, then everything will improve? Well, but wasn't he a lobbyist? So isn't it a chance? No? Wherever there's risk, there's maybe a part of a chance. For the yearbook. All right, so also there was a few data security, less data security because the police wanted to actually save and analyze more data. Our argument was kind of simple. The systems don't work, and we noticed that. So we don't need 6 months of data retention to find out that the system actually doesn't work. So behind this is the following: the data that your providers will actually give out once you have a subpoena, that is the data that's being collected to for data retention actually. So they go to a court and say, like, dear judge, please give us these data, this data that actually exists. And so actually these heaps of data is actually are actually like improving and like getting larger and larger, and all kinds of different cases will take use of these data. So there's two like ideas about security. So the security of the state and the security of our data, and they actually compete with each other. So our closing arguments is always one last thing. The trust problem that the BSI has is not being solved right now. This is just we have to say that all the time, and everyone is just nodding, and including Mrs. Merkel. But then that's our word.
This wasn't too surprising, even though in the Interior Ministry they were of different opinions. But we are very much used to having experts in charge that don't really know what they're doing. I talked to a person who was working on actually spelling out the IT security law and proposed some changes. And he said, well, we had to do something, and that's what we did. We follow the check mark, we check that point. And I can't say I have that much passion for enterprises, but in that case, I have.
Also diesen Ökonomen dort irgendwie zum BSI-Vorsitzenden machen zu wollen.
Now, the idea of making this cyber clown the new president of the BSI, we first saw the idea 1st of April. But having him as a president for creative and digital economy would have made a lot more sense. We are sure that this Peter Borny, who's who has studied music and would be a way better fit for the digital economy. It's surprising that this content lobbyist, on a scale of copyright extremist, is very, very far out. They set him on this list. It's really surprising to have the government placing him, Dieter Thorny, on that far out list. It wasn't just a positive year. We're not going to talk further about this. He didn't say much more about this. A bit like the data protection responsible. We hope that in 2016 he is actually going to fulfill his duties. Other news matching the motto of this Congress, we have, together with the Free Software Foundation Europe, published a press release about the right to tinker. The right to tinker with your own devices to install other kinds of software. These problems have grown over the years, have changed from just being about computers to being about all kinds of devices. We have talked about this issue for the last couple of years, but we actually wanted to issue a press release because it applies to so many different kinds of consumer devices, like tablets and smartphones and consoles and cars, computers, anything basically. The debate about this topic in the Anglo-Saxon space has expanded on, has continued far beyond what it is in Germany. There have been court cases about it, and we wanted to set a clear position against the culture of companies having to give permission to tinker with their devices and actually establishing a right to tinker.
Zum Ende des Jahres noch beschlossen, den Routerzwang
And the Bundestag has, towards the end of the year, stopped the forced placement of routers. So now, in Germany, citizens are actually free to install their own software on their home router and not obligated to use the devices from their telcos. This has been supported by the Freifunk community. Lots of witnesses from that community have given their expertise and their testimony to actually build some understanding for the issue in the courts. And we expect this to end up in a usable law by next year. And by then we should actually be able to install the software we want to on our own devices, and we welcome this development. In May we issued a press release on the AKVorrat in Austria, which was the voice for data protection and against data retention in Austria. And there is still a campaign running in Austria until the 19th of January by this AKVorrat Österreich that is attempting, just continuing the case towards the highest court in Europe to stop Austria from actually implementing data retention. I have to add that the AKVorrat is quite tight in terms of finances. So if you can actually manage to add a Christmas gift to them, they would surely appreciate it. Mid-May in Cologne, we had the first 1C2, the Chaos Cologne, which was an experiment with how artists and hackers could work together to improve the world. It was combined with youth hacking for artists, and we had 300 to 400 very engaged artists and hackers coming together who will continue the same thing next year, and we have made very positive experiences.
Also wir werden da der sehr viele lokale Veranstaltungen im CCC gibt, nicht mehr jeder einzelne erwähnen können. Das ist leider.
Because there are so many local events organized by the CCC, we will not be able to continue to mention every single one of them in our years in review here, but we will be talking about some of them, a select few.
Nicht mehr jeder einzelne nennen können. Wir haben versucht, die mal.
Unfortunately, we won't be able to mention every single one. Our fear has not proved real of that because of all those small events, the attendance at Congress will be smaller, so there's still a lot of people here, and most of these small talks are even broadcast on video, so we appreciate the development of these new small events throughout Germany. Constanze, what happened to your complaint against Germany?
Well, I'm just going to mention there were several individual people were involved, including the CCC, with a long-lived complaint. So in June, we once again added some more paperwork. Well, we're not going to stop. We wanted to hear from the Attorney General some kind of. We would also have rejected, wouldn't accept a response, we would have accepted a negative response. Well, our demand is that they inquire and start an investigation against those responsible in the government. Well, due to for espionage or aiding and abetting espionage, well, they should perhaps, consider starting an investigation. Well, obvious. Well, we just, given the jubilee, even the anniversary of Snowden, we once again added some more. And indeed, we got an answer shortly thereafter. We got, indeed, we got an actual mail about after 1.5 years. Interesting letter, which we obviously published online on CCD, where the Attorney General answered us a long email, which hardly answered our paperwork, but talked a lot about Merkel's telephone, which we don't really care about. Well, if you stop the complete surveillance, they can keep surveilling Merkel's telephone. It's a weird, very weird letter. It wasn't a yes-no answer either. So he neither said that there was the initial suspicion, so they will start an investigation, nor did they say that they will not start one. It's a bit like a Schrödinger's cat. Is the cat dead, isn't it? You want to look inside? No. Well, we obviously knew that at this point, didn't know at this point that the Attorney General, that his days were numbered. Well, that indeed, it wasn't clear at the beginning of July, but nevertheless, we want to encourage all of you to inform yourselves about the contents of the suit, and you can indeed use them during the day-to-day work. Well, and you can know if you know about this very popular TV. We asked them this amazing final question: which club in 2014 sued all of the members of the of the government? Well, Nexus looked the whole program, about 40 minutes. Did they find out? No, all I heard was that people looked at it. I heard that people looked at it, watched it. Did anyone know how much they got for the answers? Nexus watched it. No, I didn't. All right, a lot of money. The answer is yes. I'm not sure if he won or not. Oh, it doesn't matter. I don't think they did. They didn't know. No, probably not. No. All right. Before we carry on, before we go back to the Attorney General, we want to mention one more thing, which we haven't talked about. So, we have a question. We have a new Attorney General. What did he say? What he said? Oh, nothing. Well, we have another 2 years. Well, yeah, indeed. In December, we talked again with our lawyers if we should submit another set of documents. Some more things came out. We could hope that the new person could maybe start an investigation or stop, which would also like, well, because if they stop the investigation, then they can do something. Well, I can just imagine if you start and there's lots of paper, you have to. Well, I think the Attorney General has a big box with hot potatoes. And he has to pick a random one. Well, the thing that I found very interesting, a lot of people during the treason affair, there was a lot of interesting debate regarding this instruction, the power to instruct. Well, when does the Justice Ministry tell the Attorney General to do something? Well, the statement that was said many times was that in principle, the Justice Ministry can only instruct if they see a very clear breach of law. And this has been done very, very rarely in the history of the Republic. Well, and interestingly, I'd like to flip it around and look at the question of investigation. Is it just a legal question that you can't just start any kind of investigation, not even a small inkling of doubt, just for a breach of German law from the side of the government and from the secret services? I want to know what kind of rule is being applied. Well, if there's a political means that the laws are also valid for secret services, we should definitely demand that. Like I see. Well, we don't completely disagree. Well, you have to imagine, it's a very radical request that secret services should follow the law. Yeah, well, I mean, Well, if you think about the interpretation of the secret services have about the laws, you can think about yesterday. Look at yesterday's, and we also have tonight once more a repeat of the craziest scenes in the NSA talk. I have to come back to the track somehow. All right. Just briefly regarding this government Trojan, the CCC once again gave a statement regarding this matter, and it's a long suit, and it's against the law regarding the Federal Criminal Bureau. And those people who are interested in the camp, a few days later I talked about it, how what kind of arguments we gave. Obviously the statement is public, but I also told you what kind of things were talked about. Talked about the kernel of the privacy and the research into such privacy, and many, many other questions that are thrown up by this law, including the infiltration into IT systems. We had hoped slightly that there would be some kind of ruling in 2015, but I think we can now expect in the spring of 2016. Well, I'm very certain, having listened, that some laws of this, some bits of this law are going to be against the Constitution. We have to think about which parts, and we can be certain that the Ministry of Interior, well, it will be very, very, once again, they will be very happy about the clarification. Well, it's important for us that we all participate and interpret this, the ruling, and transform them into demands. We should make sure that they don't once again paste the parts of the rulings into just a new law. And we should really keep at it, given that we are the people who dealt with the Trojan ourselves. I have to complete the fact that the pieces of the ruling would make the population unsure. Oh, we don't want to, unsettle anyone. All right. Anyway, those people who are interested can download the camp talk, the presentation I gave at the tank, where I explain and I talk some legal foo as well. All right. Well, we also participated in the whole tour regarding the treason. And tomorrow at 4, there's once more. At 4 o'clock, there's once again to talk about it, and we'll clarify it. And Markus Bechtel already talked about it at the camp together with Andre. So people who are interested, they can look at it. Well, obviously, we also published our statement. Wanted to publish a statement ourselves. And the hackers from Berlin also went to the demonstration, but not that big, but big given the time we had. Well, we don't have to talk about any further. People are interested, and someone who's been under a rock some until now, they can look at the presentation from the camp. Just a couple more points, actually. All right. Well, don't look so unhappy. All right. In the end, you will ask people to commit treason again, and it's going to be a mess. Well, you're now on record. I think Markus will say that which is necessary tomorrow. Actually, it's today, isn't it? It's at 4. Well, this whole space-time continuum in the CCI, it's a bit of a beard. Have you been in the lounge? All right. We have one more anomaly that starts in the summer and goes in the end, which we call plentiful data. Oh, well, this plenty of data comes from KPMG, I think, some like consulting firm, which demanded just before the IT we should move away from this whole data protection. We should move to, data plenty, because this is it's the oil in the 21st century. Well, we think that's a very peculiar logic. So we, that's why we started mentioning any instances of this plentiful of data. We mentioned them, and we kept using this term to make it clear that we're all very rich. And we're all, there's a lot of data, usually available as a torrent, usually other people's data. And the examples this year are, they're not very different, like as in the first year. It's just more data. The quantity in data that is just, it's just climbing and climbing. Starting the first Internet of Things miracles, including Hello Kitty, Internet of Things stuff, including personal data of American Secret Services and of the other members of the federal government. Well, the official management is the central Bureau for Management, Personal Management, and they lost all their data somehow, in all directions, including the files, the lie detector research, which was done against an investigation, which was done against potential employees, including if you want to start working in the Secret Service, you'll ask about all sorts of very embarrassing things. Oh, they're all saved digitally. Oh, well, we then discovered that the administration was outsourced to some random company, which put them on a random server in the abroad. Well, very funny. Anyway, this kind of case of being rich and plentiful in data has accompanied us since, and we have to admit... Well, we got more and more cynical during the years, and our answers became more and more terse. Well, what more can you really say? If you think about this ideology of plentiful data, well, you could do everything, because you could do something useful with it at some point. Well, it's inevitable that something like this happens. Well, this, given the state of IT security, it's inevitable. Well, this is kind of a contrast that we're creating, the juxtaposition between the trust, loss in trust in the IT security. Well, since summer, and herself, in particular, given the publisher, the Union of Publishers started circulating the different view of the government, how they look at big data, and this includes this weird term, plentiful data. You can just look at the whole fragments, for example, Dobrindt or Simon Gabriel. You can find them, that they're all identical to the statements that the consultant makes. About at the same time, you should stop being so skeptical about data. We thought that was very interesting. That has to do with the public opinion and these annoying data skeptics. It was interesting to look. To note that there was a new plan and a new idea. Well, in the end, people who look at IT risk, well, they're annoying. They disturb the whole big data hub. It was an interesting linguistic development since the summer. And interestingly enough, well, whenever our data protection people want to participate, they are 3 years behind. So they look up about the debate. So the big agency are saying, "Oh, we exaggerated a bit too much. People feel like they're being investigated too much. We should maybe think about ourselves whether this big data is helping us at all." This debate is beginning just in the USA, but here, there's consulting idiots are still part of the discussion and say, "Oh, it's more data is best." Well, I don't know how many of you. Well, you don't have to raise your hand. Please don't raise your hand. Do you know? Have you seen a Merkel speech? Anyway, I did as part of this. I look at one completely as part of this at the economy union about 7 minutes. So Merkel's speeches are very 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 lengthy. Well, you don't fall over from passion. But the bit about data where they really becomes passionate, I couldn't believe it. It's like, all right, she had a real moment of anger and sort of outrage. There's no highlight, but this one bit about these annoying data protection people, these are super annoying. I mean, that was very interesting. I think we'll keep hearing more and more about it from the various ministries I have no doubt about it. Well, I'm sure there's going to be another case of, you know, plenty of data from an Eastern ministry. All right, let's stop. We needed a break from this whole politics. All right, we took the break, and everyone has to... Now we have to all leave the stage, or what?
Nothing here is facing the correct way. Welcome to Canada.
Okay.
Yay.
Massachusetts.
Yes.
New idea or a new structure, trying to figure out how something's going to be put together. There's no better place than be walking the alleys here, these paths at midnight or 2 a.m. They're still running, and it's just got an energy level of optimism. Technology can be changed and shaped to serve our society better. These aren't just IT staffs that are just doing clocking in, day out. These are the people that have a social purpose of making the world better through their technology.
Das Spielfeld verlässt oder Umfeld hat verloren. Und es gibt Punktabzug für Hightech. Nice.
and who wasn't there, I'd say, yeah, unlucky people.
And this is a small call. This video was a trailer to a film that a docu-team did at camp, and they filmed 8 days with 5 kilos of cameras and audio and 275 gigabytes of pictures, a lot of tone and a lot of material, and they were pretty exhausted but happy. They're here again, have filmed on day minus three and walked there 16 kilometers, and they're doing their best. They want to do a documentary, and there's an Indiegogo crowdfunding thing, so they can realize that, and you can find it under egigi.me/at/allcreatureswelcome. That's the title of the film. That's the hashtag for your favorite social media. And I'll put the link on Twitter to video where you can see it. This was the better audio. Sorry for fucking that up. I think we can understand this because the docu team understands the hacker community really well and is able to put them into picture. And nobody else has this much material, and we have to buy ourselves free of this stuff. So when I saw this trailer for the first time for this film, I thought, first, I want back there, saying this is the camp. One doesn't have to say anymore. I think it's ingenious. Well, if you haven't been there, go there in 4 years. Up next, few smaller events. It's not just camps and congresses, but the ERFAS as well. Let's start with the MRM CD. Meta Rhein-Main Chaos Days. They have a feature. I don't know how they organize it, but the point is, you get a welcome pack if you go there and have nice design every time, by the way. This medal, a higher, faster, farther, you get with the tickets and the bands. You get a embroidered towel, a bio muesli, a cup. Interesting concept. Maybe we should do something. This with 12,000 people, no. Okay, maybe not for the biggest thing. You can do the bio muesli out of the region, as I would wanted to say. It's a big bigger this region, I'd say. We have some there similar in size. For example, the Hackover.
War von euch jemand da?
Ja, du.
Who was there? Yeah, you. Oh, okay.
Hackover
had the little problem that the tickets were sold out, even pre-sale, which is a bit sad. On the other hand, yeah, cool that you want to go there. On the other hand, same problem as the Congress. Thought to make a geek end for hackerspaces in northern Germany. Northern Germany? Yeah, approximately. It's Lower Saxony.
Grundsätzlich hat dieses Konzept von Anfang an nicht funktioniert.
Basically, this concept didn't work at all from the beginning, because from all Germany and in Switzerland there came people, and it's nice sitting together and things happen. I think we like the smaller things because there's this chaos family feeling. They're here as well because of the assemblies, but on the smaller things, we like it a bit more. Yeah, there's things happening that don't happen on the Congress because it's not as personally, and we need far more of these small things, because there's some distribution, you know. Okay, so if your Alpha Circle wants to do any event, do it and talk with people who do them, with Anstil and Hackover, Datenspuren, and so on. It's not that hard. It's nice for hacker spaces if people do something where they all have to participate. And it's really cool afterwards when you did it and can show off a bit. Do it. It's really nice. You can do it with the university, not always, but you can get some money at the most of cities. CCC, federal thing, will help a bit with finances, or if you can put money for VOC, likes to help if you're big enough. So we have the infrastructure to do these things. It's a lot of technic equipment you can use. Plan long time beforehand, not 3 weeks before, but maybe half a year, so you can start organizing. But then just do it. It is fun. Look, the calendar and the other things are running, so there are no overlaps. Thanks. Hannover, if you're not sold out, you have some structures where you can go. They're empty at the time. Maybe you can get a big bidder, a bit bigger. The next Hackover, yeah, please register. They have the space. Yeah, we want to do this scaling up, but in this building where we have our room, it's very cozy. And the building, we know it. It's very nice there. Things happen in back rooms, and people put out the pianos and sing the International. Yeah, I heard it. And the Datenspuren in Dresden have grown. 1,000 visitors, they moved from the Scheunenviertel, I don't know how it's called, to a museum of techniques. It's a beautiful museum, too. And they have a date for next year's. And it's the 22nd to 23rd October. We don't want to report too much for that. There are some talks you can download. Just go there, it's for free. You can take some time to look at the technical stuff as well. We don't really have time, so just skip content. I didn't want to say anything. He was the keynote speaker. Well, just thought it's a really nice local. Just have to look if you can find just a big museum for the Congress, but there's a lot of decoration for nerds and hardware. There's a nice computer exhibition. That's really a nice choice. And Datenspuren, yeah, I can only recommend. Yeah, I learned it's the most visited museum in Germany. What it is, it's a BMW museum. Could ask if they have space. No, let's not do this. Yeah, well, we want to say with the Dresden example, with all the things we could not recall, were regional CCC groups, ERFAs, Freifunk groups, Chaos-Treff groups, worked for different refugees projects in Dresden alone. There are 25 camps that got a Freifunk, Internet for Refugees. And in Berlin, there was a bigger campaign that I really found nice, the support refugees and emancipation campaign. It was a big donation campaign. People connected and helped. Got even bigger, and it animated a lot of people. Wanted to put it all together, but we had a press release only in October, where we pointed at different smaller projects. It's not just in one campaign, and but it's really interesting because there, yeah, was a lot of donations, €48,000. I don't know. It looked at this three weeks ago. There was a little auction in Berlin. Yeah, I don't know. In December, it was €48,000 for hardware, software, and stuff. Interesting thing for the refugees. Emancipation is for refugees by refugees. We just give them money, and they just do what they think it's right and build structures that are needed. And that's pretty important for the sustainability thing, because they look that the internet cafes are cared for, that administered, that are workshops. And it's a bit sad that they do have to make this their own, because the most camps don't have internet. Food is there sometimes, I heard, but it's catastrophic, and I'm happy and proud that our community, as a lot of others, are helping where we can. And our community can do internet, other people do it with other means, and I want to thank them as well.
Vielleicht zu guter Letzt, wir sind über uns rein so ein bisschen Zeit weg, aber es ist natürlich eine Form.
Time is running, but well, form of empowerment came from catastrophe, from emergency. There may be a little learning process to learn something if they have to maintain their own stuff. The Freifunker did a lot, the whole federal region. There's a talk today from Ruhr region, Essen. Yeah, but we can't really talk about this, we don't have the time. I want to talk about Chaos Radio, because there are nice topics, and there was talk about refugees and hackers that I thought I'd like, because there came a big hardware donation. 20 pallets of computers and monitors that were donated, and yeah, that got done a lot. So principally, the Chaos Radio has a kind of dual mode, a studio at Fritz or at the Berlin CCC. The VOC is helping, you can look at, hear the stream and download it. The numbers are 9,500 people per episode. Yeah, there are other radio podcast things and other Alpha circles, but we can't talk about them too much. There are really a lot of funny, interesting, partly regular, partly non-regular. Might have to make a summary about that, but yeah, just do it sometime else. One can find it in the Doku Wiki. Oh, there is no Doku Wiki. Is that a wiki again? There is read-only access to the wiki from the side of the building. The event blogs are clickable again, but not with all things. Oh, well, writable access is coming. With the technicians, you are the technician.
Wir wollen stellvertretend auch noch mal, also das ist so ein bisschen.
Well, we want to talk. It's got a lit, put under the rug, because there were so many Freifunk projects. There was this example by the CCC Freiburg, where there are crypto parties regularly. In Hamburg. In Hamburg, there's a crypto. Visit time if you have special problems. 24 Alphas have crypto parties regularly. Freiburg help with refugees stuff as well, and a lot of Alphas help there. And
mal, und da sind doch ganze Menge angereist nach Berlin zu einer.
We met Berlin to a big demo we called against TTIP. I never saw such a big demo in Berlin for a long time, where a lot of people came from, a lot of people.
War dann unmittelbarer Laufnähe sehen konnte. Hat sich also
as you can see by filling up the central station, you can see there.
Es ja in dem TTIP-Abkommen auch so einige fragwürdig, insbesondere.
The TTIP thing, there are a lot of suspicious things with copyright and data laws, data protection stuff. And the whole critics that a lot of NGOs use is the whole intransparency thing. And it's dangerous, yeah.
Okay.
There's another thing I have to say something. Yeah, well. Yeah, the positive first. The boys and girls from the Let's project. Try to do domain validated certificates for everyone. For example, Chaos Computer Club. So we have certificates signed by this. The negative is we are not the right target group because the software took a week to put it right, to take a certificate from the system. There are a lot of other projects now that use the same protocol, but have it easier and easier program languages as, for example, Shell, to get the certificates, but we never have this problem again.
Danke, Let's Encrypt.
Thanks, Let's Encrypt. There are now over 200,000. If you have questions there in the program, Mr. Showmaker will answer some questions. I don't know, 200,000 was the number? Well, I don't know, he will talk about it, he's in the program. You can go there, clap a bit. It was a bit to the end of the year. And a lot of people from the community clicked the certificates. Try to make it short. Yeah, I want to go to the end, okay? Yeah. I want to end with some positive notes some way, because there are a few things that are still running that are at least interesting in with the Secret Services. CCC had a press statement of that in March. We're doing with Privacy International and with internationally providers. As you can see on the complaints writing, where we speak before the Powers Tribunal of Great Britain, where we can complain against the Secret Services, namely the GCHQ. We can say there were some things from the IPT in the last year, and the practice of the GCHQ were partially declared illegal, partially not. Our thing was not with the surveillance, but with hacking practices of the GCHQ. And the orders that got from the IPT, from this secret court, came with the mass surveillance, the 10-Power program. And the British government has put out practical orders to circle the Secret Services. In this case, they did something else. They put out the Computer Misuse Act, law, where the hackers that are infiltrating systems for the GCHQ are free from police work.
Gerichtshof für Menschenrechte
and for the European Court for Human Rights. We will bring it in too with others. There is a clip from December. The complaint was adjourned. It was important, but it was put back because there were other things, orders in Great Britain. They put it back, pulled it back, and the British government will talk about this. And the act was repealed, and we can now talk about it in Strasbourg.
Okay, so I see you're looking forward to this as much as we are. So we'll be sure to talk about it a lot. Right. So first answer to the question, So why don't we build a larger Congress Center by ourselves? That's the first answer to the question, what to do with the space in the Congress Center. So Linus, could you create an Indiegogo campaign for this, please? Right. So can I say something for myself, please? Can we ask the people who created the Berlin Airport to build a new Congress Center? All right. Or maybe we'll ask Lego if they built us a new, or if they sponsor us some pieces. So are we done? I would like to thank Wintermute for the nice sticker that decorates my laptop. It's a black and a red flag, and it says large coalition. And it makes me meet lots of interesting people on Twitter, for example, who think they have to rant at me. So the largest person, the most interesting person was Lutz Bachmann, who put me on his list, because it's very obvious that the Chaos Computer Club is hacked the leftist party in the name of the government, and this sticker is actually the proof of that. So lots of conspiracy theories here. Right. From us, this was the year in review, also out of the view of the Chaos Computer Club. Thank you for listening, and we hope that you'll support our public work also in 2016. Thank you.